Hello, and welcome to Intro to the Linux Shell. I'm Philip, and in this course, you'll learn the basics of how to use the Linux Shell or command line environment.
And I'm Carl. The goal of this course is to give you the basic command line tools you'll need to start working with Linux servers. Now, you might have used other command lines before. If you've used JavaScript, you've probably seen the JavaScript console in your browser. Or maybe you've used an interpreter in Python or another language. Or perhaps you've used the command line on your own computer.
These are all examples of command line interfaces. Command line interfaces all work in about the same way. You type in a command, then the system runs those commands and displays the output. Then you can type another command, and so on.
Now, the idea of a command line interface goes back to the mid-20th century and one of the earliest ways that people had for communicating with a computer, the computer terminal. Now, today, terminal usually means a piece of software, but it originally meant a physical piece of hardware for interacting with a computer. Before terminals, people put programs and data through computers using punch cards, loading a batch of data into the computer all at once. The terminal, by letting a user directly send commands to a computer program and immediately see responses, was a huge step forward in user interface.
And it's an interface that we're still using today, for a lot of reasons. A command line interface is programmable, it's efficient in terms of network bandwidth, and you can use the terminal to edit files in a distant system without having to first copy them to your local machine. In general, you can be much more expressive with a text-based interface than you can by just pointing and clicking. One of the uses of the shell is to administer servers, machines that might be far away on the network and that probably don't have a graphical environment. For the rest of this course, you're going to be working on a system very much like that.
So first, you'll need to set up your own virtual Linux server to work on. Fortunately, that's a lot easier than it sounds like. So, let's get started.